threading its way along the mountainside, a BNSF intermodal train descends into the Victor Valley on a windy afternoon. By now, those of you who follow my channel regularly know that I like to try and focus on the ever-changing landscape of SoCal railroading. Some changes are to be expected, new motive power, signaling systems, and even operational procedures. However, I recently found a change I never expected. My beloved water resource road crossing looks like it's being torn up. This crossing was once used by water crews to access the nearby aqueduct, but for as long as I've been around, it's been closed to the public. Our first catch of the day rolls past what is now probably the world's safest grade crossing. Another eastbound BNSF intermodal screams past, this time with international containers. With the eastbound hauling past, a Union Pacific train rounds the turn and takes center stage, showing us the true face of Uncle Pete's new precision scheduled railroading policy. After being held at Lugo for a short time, the train receives a green signal and is on the move again. Now I want to point out that the signals at Lugo are roughly a mile away, and even with the head end that far away, we still haven't seen half of this train yet. It's pretty safe to say that this is probably the longest train I've ever seen in my life. Even though precision scheduled railroading is proving to be quite unpopular with rail customers and rail fans, you have to admit it's producing some rather impressive consists. With the 3-mile monster now proceeding on its way towards Cajon Pass, a more modestly sized BNSF train comes into view. Four GEs are on the head of this intermodal train as they thunder past on their way into the Inland Empire. Now, how exciting would it be if I were to tell you that on this day I caught 3751 leading a freight train? Yeah, 3751. Well, here you go. Here's BNSF 3751 leading a freight train out of Barstow towards Los Angeles. I had you going there for a second, didn't I? Last catch of the day is a humble bear table train on its way to the port to pick up some more containers. What the future holds for this rail fanning location of mine remains to be seen, but it sure will be interesting to see what it looks like the next time I pay a visit. For now, I'm TrainTrackTrav. I'll see you trackside. Thanks for watching.